it's me, Stormy, and here is your annual horoscope for the year of 2020, and welcome to a new decade. This is a very exciting time. We're just getting to be a part of the world getting different, and talking about things getting different, Leo, this is a year of some things getting different for you, especially in regards to relationships. It's going to be a really interesting year around relationships, and the one thing I want to tell you right at the beginning of the forecast to keep in mind is that as Saturn gets ready to step into Aquarius, which will happen in March, he'll back out of it and then he'll come back into it in December until 2023. The focus of relationships here is Saturn is leveling you up, right? He's saying we've got to come to a new place, a new level, the next level. So if you are married, not married, in a relationship that is just kind of running out of steam, any one of these places, relationships, business and personal, will begin to have some action for you for sure. Not to mention we have got 6 eclipses happening this year, and this will also put some energy into your social axes, which will bring some new life into your relationships, new passion, new play, new social things. So these are all wonderful energies we'll get to work with. But keep in mind, Saturn here is not acting as a malefic energy. He's not a bad energy. He's coming along, Leo, to say there's some cracks in this cement. You either got to fill them in or let the cement go. Whatever it is, Saturn is going to put some energy into your relationships, and I hope that you'll put as much energy in back to make the corrections that need to be made there. Now, other things that are happening is, of course, it's a big year astrologically. We've got Saturn and Pluto coming together in a conjunction at the beginning of the year, Jupiter and Pluto conjuncting 3 different times throughout the year, April, June, and November. Mercury is going to retrograde, like always, 3 different times this year. And at the end of the year, we'll have the great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn, which is a big deal since they are the rulers of the age, and we will be moving towards the age of Aquarius. So, big year, lots of stuff going on, but it is also just another year where we can only take one 24-hour period at a time. So let's jump in and talk about a little bit of what's coming up for you. I will do an overview of the year, and then I will break it down every month and every week as we continue to go along, okay? So like I said, Mercury is going to retrograde per usual 3 times this year. It'll be in February, July, and October, and we'll cover that a little bit more in depth when I do the monthly breakdowns. But you can also go back to my 2019 Mercury retrograde in your element video, because that's going to be very helpful carrying over into 2020 as well. And that's the other thing I want to bring your attention to. Some of the things that we're coming into 2020 with are not new to you. You're bringing them over from 2019, but now you're perfecting them and perfecting that work or making the necessary adjustments. Now on January 10th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening at 20 degrees of Cancer. This is going to light up your 12th house space. So it's going to bring shifts for about the next 6 months. Things that have been hidden or in hiding or haven't been available to your sight or there's been confusion around them, they will be available. That lunar eclipse is going to shed a lot of light on something that has been hidden. Now, just a couple days later on January 12th, we've got Saturn and Pluto coming together in their conjunction at 22 degrees of Capricorn. This is going to light up your 6th house space. Now, 2 thoughts. First of all, when Saturn and Pluto come together, they only come together about every 34 years, and these are the big energies. So when they come together, this is a part of your evolutionary process, but it's slow. There's nothing speeding towards you with this energy. Plus, we've got a lot of retrograde happening this year, so there's no speed, but you're making an adjustment in your 6th house area, your daily routine, your work, your health. If you own a business or you're self-employed, that area, co-workers, people you co-mingle with, right? It's going to bring an energy here that says that this needs to evolve. My suggestion to you is to be prepared and be honest about what's looking in front of you. And it also gives me this sense with this lunar eclipse coming from the 12th house that perhaps in the 6th house, something's being revealed from the 12th house that lights up information in your 6th house. So this can also be a loss, right? Something that feels like a loss, but it is a loss that is immediately replaced with the right thing. So let's say you do multiple freelance jobs and you have to let one of them go, you will instantly be replaced with something else that is a better fit for you. Or maybe you just get your energy, your time, your health, your wellness back. Maybe a coworker gets fired, something like that. Who knows? There's something coming though from that 12th house space of the lunation that connects with this Saturn-Pluto situation, which just be prepared and know that there's going to be shifts in this area, and I think that you'll be good to go and navigate forward. March 22nd, Saturn is going to take this step into the energy of Aquarius. So this is where, right here at the beginning of the year, you're going to start to have a focus, a feeling, an intensity, more responsibility, more obligation. It can kind of feel like a heavier energy in the area of your relationships. And it can feel heavier at first because Saturn comes in and he's serious about helping you come to the next level. So you may feel that. You may take on more responsibilities in some kind of relationship. It could even be a business relationship. But expect that Saturn's little snip here, because this is just a treat. He's not staying here right now. He's not going to be in fully in place until December. But this trip from March to July through your seventh house is going to bring up your attention to your relationships. I'm telling you, even if you're in the happiest marriage ever, you're going to take on new responsibilities in some way, shape, or form, or just seal up any cracks or wiggles that have been dealing and happening over there. And it's just the right time to do so. Now, we've got these three different times that Jupiter and Pluto are going to come together. April 4th, June 30th, and November 12th. When these guys come together, we are here for this, Leo. This is such a good pocket of opportunity for you. It's like supercharged. It's intensely focused. There's an opportunity here in front of you and available. You can take advantage of it, and you are driven. You are focused. It is like taking a very big leap forward. So make sure that you use these energies. This is brilliantly going to be happening in your sixth house. Your health, your wellness, your career, freelance kind of projects that you do, anything that has to do with that area of your life, you'll have the opportunity to move some things forward. If you need to hire some new people, you know, even if you've been working on your own or you've been working at the same place for a long time, if it's time for fresh faces to be in there, this is a wonderful opportunity to surge and to grow this particular area. May 13th through June 25th, we've got Venus taking a retrograde in the energy of Gemini. Now, this is going to light up your 11th house. So this is our first sneak peek of the year. The 11th and 5th house axes will be lit up. So this is the place where I'm telling you guys, you have an opportunity for not only to use that energy of relationships, because Saturn is still there in Aquarius at this time, but in this particular retrograde, you're going to look back and see which relationships in your friendships, your organizations, your social spheres, even in your long-range plans, which relationships, which financial plans feel like there's not life, there's not love there anymore. And it doesn't mean that you're going to cut them off, right? It doesn't mean you disconnect from your organization, but it may mean that you have to make some adjustments to bring that harmony, to bring that love, bring that sensuality, bring that harmony and that good juju that Venus is all about to the table. Now, it's still a retrograde, you guys. It's still a retrograde. So one of the things I definitely think of is, of course, from a friendship zone or someone from your past could walk in, maybe an ex wants another chance with you, right? Or something like that. And you can evaluate if this is the right choice for you and you have the benefit of Saturn over there in your seventh house to say, yes, this person has changed enough, we can move forward, even a business partnership. So use your Venus retrograde as a friendly time throughout your 11th house to see which connections are still solid and valid. June 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse in Sagittarius. So this lights up your fifth house. So 11th and fifth house axes are lit up, you guys. Now, with this lunar eclipse in Sagittarius, because it's in the fifth house, one of the things that I have a sense of for you is that, one, you're going to look over where your life and your world have been lacking in joy. You need joy. You need laughter. You need passion, Leo. And if those things have been a little bit more low key, you might be in a position where you're feeling like you need to bring up the volume of that. And I very, very much so support that for you. But the other thing with this lunar eclipse happening here, especially being opposite this Venus retrograde, is I do not suggest starting a new romance, but I think that by clearing out with that Venus retrograde, but also having this lunar eclipse in the fifth house, this gives you a fresh start, a fresh place for passion, for play, for these second chances at expressing something in life that you wanted to. I think that it gives you an opportunity in this wrap-up of energy to have a new fantastic conception of something come to your table, whether it's a conception of a business idea, poetry, children, your fresh beginning. Right here opposite that retrograde is actually showing you where your love is, whether that's for work, people, places, or things. This will actually be very good. Now, the other thing I do think of, because it is a Venus retrograde, is again, it's gonna show you where you're not showing up getting the love, or where you're not showing up giving the love, and you can start to do that with that lunar eclipse. On the 21st of June, we've got a solar eclipse in the energy of Cancer, so 12th house. And then on the 5th of July, we've got a lunar eclipse in Capricorn, so the 6th house. This is going to end the work of the Capricorn Cancer axis. So your 12th house and your 6th house, this is going to be a time, I think, with these particular eclipses that are happening here, where you'll have the opportunity to actually make fresh starts in these particular areas. The ones that were happening at the beginning of the year, I think, were shining a lot of light, saying we need your attention over here, you need to kind of revive this area. But now you've got clarity between your 12th house and your 6th house to make some starts here. What's a project, or what's something that's been hidden that's ready to come to light? You've got a lot going on in relationships. Are you ending a relationship? Are you guys gonna go to counseling? Does this business relationship need to be adjusted in some way, shape, or form? Are you ready to come out of hiding, Leo, and be actually in connection and collaboration with some other businesses, or maybe adjust something of your own? It's certainly an energy. Ooh, for some of you, this may be a new medical practitioner as well. So kind of stick that in your hat if that's what's happening for you around about this time, okay? September 9th through November 13th, we've got Mars very comfortably retrograding in the energy of Aries. And I say he's comfortable because he rules the energy of Aries. So this is not an entirely uncomfortable turnaround. But Mars is action, movement, assertion, aggression, a little bit of conflict in there, right? But whatever you think about when you think about Mars, just know that arrow has got him in motion, right? So the way you're doing things, the way you're taking action on things, your desires, this retrograde is pointing you to re-looking back at your ninth house. What are your beliefs? We've had a Venus retrograde go on. What are your beliefs about you deserving love, right? What are your beliefs that have been moving out of the way so that you can let love into your life, so that you can let some new ideas, so that you can let some new suggestion, learning, information, expansion into your life, right? With Mars here in the ninth house too, I would very seriously look at where your identity has been attached to a belief that's not working for you anymore, Leo. Where can you shed that and let that go? Where are you out of education and information and you need to take some classes, you need to get some kind of certification going or something like that? Because Mars is an energy that is kind of warring, right? There's a conflict going on there too. This could also walk a past legal situation into your life. Whatever that is, what I can tell you is if it walks back into your life, that's fine. I would highly suggest you not start legal action during a Mars retrograde. Typically, the person who starts it during the retrograde is the one who loses it. So keep that in mind, okay? We also recommend during a Mars retrograde, if you can avoid it, not to have any surgery, since Mars is over conflict and cutting and warring things, and your surgeon and your surgery itself would be wrapped up in this Mars retrograde. That said, life on life's terms. If you've got to have surgery, honey, go and do it, okay? We do not stop our lives because the planets are doing a thing. Take care of you. All right, November 30th, we've got a lunar eclipse that's happening in Gemini. December 14th, we've got a solar eclipse that's happening in Sagittarius. The 11th and the 5th house axes are busy. You're out, you're brimming, you've got joy, you've got some passion behind you. You're being social, you're a part of new social groups. Not only that, from the shifts in the relationships this year, I think, Leo, you start making some new short-term and long-term plans for the goals that you want to reach, and the universe starts throwing people at you that are the right fit fit for your big new size dream, right? But I definitely would think here too, with this last lunar eclipse that we're having here, if there is a friendship or a last minute social connection that you do need to be rid of to make space for something else, that will be the time to do that. Your partnerships, and I think there's a business partnership that is pretty strong that maybe is a friendship that turns to a business partnership. That's what it looks like. So that could be something that's happening for you towards the end of the year as well. On the 17th, Saturn is going to walk back into Aquarius because he's going to retrograde in that time. So now you've got him solidly here until 2023, and you're going to work on, perfect, crystallize, and master this relationship sector of your life. On the 20th, Jupiter comes into Aquarius. We've got expansion here. There's wisdom into the work that you're doing. On the 21st, Jupiter and Saturn are going to come together in the great conjunction in your relationship house. Now, Jupiter and Saturn, when they come together, they're called the rulers of the age. They don't come together often, right? So they're the rulers of the age, and they're over economics, politics, religion, law, order, systems, medicine, all of these things. They rule over these particular energies. So we will naturally see changes coming in just the global sphere, in our own economies, wherever we are at. And this will make space for you to hook up with these correct relationships. This is a turning point for you, Leo, in the relationships that you have had in your life. It's in the energy of Aquarius, which is kind of a rebel, or they want to do things differently. They don't want to just follow what the tradition is. So if you've had unhealthy relationships or relationships that are more chaos and confusion than serenity, if any of those things have been true, your relationships in general, you'll be so serious about them going forward. But know that this is your turning point. Now, the little tip I'll give you to think about, Leo, is to look back between 2012 and 2015, when Uranus and Pluto were dancing together. What was happening for you in your relationships? What were you becoming aware of? What was this sense that you had at that time? Because you may see this as the turning point of bringing that particular set of energies to fruition. So it's going to be a year. You guys, we're going to do 2020 together. You're going to get focused on finishing up some things that you've already been working on. Some new things will come in as we travel towards the middle of the year. And then you get to start and have this whole new experience as we're moving towards the end of 2020 and heading towards 2021. I look forward to being with you every month and every week, studying with you all year long. So if there's anything I can do to help you out, let me know. Come visit me at stormygrace.com. You can also leave your manifestations of the year under this video. I love to check in with you, okay? All right, guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you very soon. Bye.